And now we have Amanda Rivera, Principal Program Manager in Power BI, sharing more about her career, the Power BI community, and Power BI with Kelly Kaye.
Well, hi, welcome. Hang on, let's just take our masks off here. Now, I'll put this over here. Hi, Amanda.
Hi, how are you?
I'm really well. How are you? It's great to see you back
in
campus. We're here in person.
It's, yes.
Feels a bit crazy, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool.
Yeah. So, I'm very happy to be here with you.
We are so excited that you're here for the Power BI Women's Summit. It's our first summit.
Exciting.
It really is. And, you know, Amanda is a principal program manager here at Microsoft. With Power BI. Mm-hmm. And, you know, Amanda is Power BI royalty, as we all know, and she's very modest. But we really, you know, see all of the beginnings of Power BI from Amanda's videos. She was certainly one of the people that I looked up to and saw her YouTube videos and learned Power BI from. So for me, it's like a bit of fandom here. So it's great to see you and you know, learning from all of your experience at Power BI. We'd love to hear about it. So how about, let's just start from the beginning. How did you start at Power BI?
I was a college hire. So I studied computer science in school. And then when I was looking at like what companies I wanted to work for full time, obviously Microsoft was exciting because, you know, Microsoft sounds fancy on a piece of paper. And then one of the other things I really liked about Microsoft was that I knew, even though I was a computer science major, that I didn't necessarily want to program my whole life. I wanted to be able to do more than that. I wanted to like work with people. And so Microsoft was one of the few companies that let college hires actually go in as a program manager directly. So I was able to interview and I was really lucky and found a great team coming right out of college. And so I was actually straight on from college right into the BI space.
I love what you just said. You know, Microsoft is definitely, you know, a resume grabber. you know, we love Microsoft, as you know, as everybody knows. But it's really lovely that you're able to come in as a PM. You know, if you don't mm-hmm. want that, you know, pure development experience.
Yes, yeah, and it's like I knew, like, just even from the projects that wasn't the type of work I wanted to do. And really, the great thing about being a PM is that you get to do so much. You get to work with the engineers, and so I still get to not use my CS degree, but, you know, still get to work with people who have a similar background. But then I also get to work with so many different types of customers and MVPs and community members and designers and basically every type of, you know, person who's part of the system I get to work with. And I love that.
It's the best of both worlds, really.
Yes, it really is. I love the job.
So how long were you at Microsoft before Power BI was launched?
2 years-ish, I would say. Like I said, I joined into the BI space, so I actually worked on PowerView to start with. For people who have been around a little bit longer, I was on PowerView first. Mm-hmm. And then, so I got to be here in that transition from like the Power Pivot, PowerView days into the like Power BI as we know it today. And so it was a very exciting ride, kind of a roller coaster, but amazing.
All of your first videos, so, you know, teaching people about this great new product. And I mean, looking ahead, looking back, I should say, wow, right?
I mean, I love that I got to be part of that journey and help introduce new people into Power BI as well. That's one of my favorite parts of the job, is that I get to meet new people and across all stages of their journey, but especially people who are just coming in, helping them like learn about the product and maybe like start new careers or things like that. It's a lot of fun.
We always are asked, you know, what do you do at Microsoft? What kind of job do you have? Do you have to be, you know, a super dev? And there are some exceptional engineers. I mean, at Microsoft, you know, women who are engineers at Microsoft. I remember working in IT, and I think 7 out of 8 of our engineers were women. So
that's great.
It was fantastic.
Yeah.
I think, you know, with looking back in your experience and launching a product and being in that kind of startup mode, and thinking about women and the community, how did you think about bringing in the community? And I ask you this because you're so engaging. Your videos were really engaging. They really taught me a lot. And this is, you know, from personal experience. I know a lot of people watch them. And they learned a lot. And it was so clear. How do you decide kind of what the message is and how to bring people in?
Well, I think a couple of different things, I would say. One is that whenever I think about like making content in general for Power BI, I really try to like talk to a person, you know, like I wanted to feel like I'm talking one-on-one with something and helping this person who is watching the video, like one-on-one, let's figure this out. Let's learn, let's figure out how, you know, how can I use this feature? What are all the details of it that I would care about? And so I try to take that person first approach. So not care so much just about like technically how the product works, but what are the scenarios they're interested in and how can I help them? So I think that's a big thing is that people first approach, I would say. And then just in general with the community, I find that whenever, and as a, I take this from a PM perspective, whenever we build products, our products are always going to be so much better if we engage with the community first to learn about their challenges. And so I think whether it's building content about the product or building the features themselves, actually spending time to talk one-on-one with people as much as I can, or if it can't be one-on-one, talking on Twitter or any kind of other community space and learning what they need really helps influence all of that content.
When you say people first, I actually felt that, you know, when I first was learning Power BI, because it was like you were talking to me, but I never realized it until you just said it. Seriously. I mean, that's what makes it good.
I think it makes it more engaging and interesting versus just like a, you know, talking head smart person just lecturing me.
Yeah.
Actually feel like you're having a conversation about it.
That's a nice revelation, learning from me today. Okay. So talk to me about, you know, being a PM here, speaking with the MVPs and engineers and being a young woman in a great tech company. Talk to me about supporting functions that Microsoft has, your team. I know personally, Arun is a huge supporter.
One of the great things about Power BI is just how many women there are. Like a lot of, even on the like the engineering side, the people actually program, a lot of the leadership are women and very like smart, brilliant women.
Yeah.
And I just, everyone here tries to make it feel like a family and they want to support you. Obviously, you still have to advocate for yourself, but you know you have the people to fall back on. So like if you're advocating for yourself, you know there's that support system there just because there's so much diversity on the team.
100%. Rupali Jain is, she's amazing, right? I think she's the partner director and she's actually head of product for Power BI at Microsoft. And so, you know, I love Rupali. I love what she's doing with the product. I love how she's thinking about the future. You know, one of my people that I look up to in the Power BI team is also Kim Manis.
Yes.
You know, Justina.
I love working all these people. I love all these people working with them. Yeah. And some of the best times I've had on the team is whenever there's been women in my leadership chain. It helps me see myself also, you know, growing in the company as well. You know, I've been here a while, but there's still, you know, so much, I'm hoping so much more left for me to grow on the team. And so it's nice to see other people even higher than me. So I know I can also achieve that.
It's great. It's a succession plan. And because you're seeing a woman leader, it's,
I know I can do it too.
Exactly. You know, and that's what we talk about in Power BI Women as well. We say, okay, we want to support support women in Power BI. And, you know, we want to grow the number of women-led user groups and expose more of the younger generation of women coming up to Power BI and the career trajectory. Who are the others? There's so many other women. I mean, I know Mathangi just joined. Sujatha is fantastic. Rosie.
Even on my team, there's so many women PMs. It's great.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's amazing. Okay, so speaking of career choices, so you've come to Microsoft. You've decided to do a balance of, you know, technical and non-technical and, you know, bringing those skills together. For somebody graduating from college and thinking about Power BI as a career, what kind of other career paths could they take that from a beginner's perspective, where could they start?
I think one of the great things about Power BI is that there's data everywhere now. And so no matter really what path you take, you can find a way to incorporate Power BI into it. Actually, a lot of like the best people I know in the community, they didn't start out like saying, I'm going to be an analyst. They started out in other careers, like they're in accounting or they're in finance or HR. And then all those places, you still have data. And so they found ways to incorporate Power BI and use that as like a leverage in their career to stand out. So not only am I really great at being an accountant, I have the skills of building reports so I can communicate all of this information better. And so I think one a great approach to take if you're not just wanting to jump straight into being an analyst is to find a way to merge that with other skills you have or other, you know, like jobs that roles you can take on and find ways to incorporate Power BI into that and use that as a way to just stand out.
It's funny that you should say that because I started in finance.
Yes, exactly. Right? You're a prime example of this. Like I said, all the best people I know.
Yeah, and it was interesting because I was a dev in a past life, or programmer, I should say. And, you know, it was interesting going into a finance org and looking at the data. And then, you know, I think it was the right place at the right time. Mm-hmm. Power BI came out and I was just super lucky. Yeah.
And just the, like I said, every role now has to interact with data in some form, whether it's I'm entering things into a tool like Dynamics or maybe I'm doing surveys and I'm getting data back from those surveys. Everything has data now.
Oh, absolutely. And you know what I love? I love, first of all, Excel and Power BI is just my favorite.
Yes.
My second and third favorite are like Teams and Power BI. And I just love Azure Synapse and Power BI. I mean, the possibilities there are just exponential. And
you actually named one of the things that are great about working on Power BI is that we have so many connections with other products as well. So we're not siloed. We get to work with all these other teams and great products and people who are passionate about these other areas. And we can find ways to build up with each other.
Yeah, exactly. And that's very similar to how we operate with our careers as well. We all, you know, help each other and build our skills and support each other. Gosh. Okay. So, you launched Power BI, you know, with the team. Of course, it's a huge team.
Very big. Very big. It was not just me. Far from it.
And
I was there. I happened to be there.
You happened to be there, right? And then, you know, the product came out. It became popular. We started the great community, you know, with Miguel Martinez, you know, Sandy, it was fantastic, right? I remember going to all of the conferences.
Oh, yeah. So much fun.
It was fantastic, right? And hopefully we'll get there one day again. But and then, you know, I was sad to see that you left for a while. I'm thinking, but this is like our Amanda. Like I was like, there's no Power BI without Amanda. You know, that's how I felt. This is a personal opinion.
Yeah, I don't think that's true for most people. But
nice. You know, I identified with you and actually in Will Thompson a lot. You know, and also, you know, Siva Harinath, who did the first dashboard in a day. So, why and what did you discover? How was that experience? Why did you make that decision? Talk to me about that.
Yeah, I had decided because I joined Power BI or BI in general at Microsoft right out of college. And so I had been here for a while. And I just felt like I needed to try something new, learn some new skills. PM roles tend to be very different depending on what company you're working for. And so I thought it would be really good for my career to just try something new and see what else is out there. So I did leave Microsoft for a little bit and I went and I worked on another team. But obviously I still was very much, you know, a family here. I had some of my best friends work on this team. I just loved the environment. And so I never completely disconnected, I would say.
Oh, God, no.
And then eventually a role did open back up on Power BI that I felt like could push me in new ways. Okay. And so that's kind of what pulled me back. You know, obviously I miss my family, but there was also, I was trying to try new things and find new ways to grow my career and new skill sets as a PM.
Yeah.
And so when a role did finally open on Power BI that could also meet those needs, it was kind of perfect. I got to grow as a PM and come back to my family. So
that's fantastic. It's wonderful that, you know, I mean, Microsoft's a great big company, but it's wonderful that you were able to find that new step, that new challenge, and kind of step out of your comfort zone by leaving and coming back shortly after, which was great. but, you know, what's the difference? What did you find was different working outside of Microsoft versus Microsoft?
One of the things that really is different between the different companies is really how much you are involved with the community and mm-hmm. how much you are involved with other aspects of building a product. So, okay. You know, there's obviously the parts of the product that all PMs do, like defining features and working with engineers and designers. But I think depending on what company you're working for, you can engage sometimes deeper in other areas like support and marketing, or you could be deeper as like a community person right. and really engaging there. And so depending on, I think, on where you work, you can kind of like pull these different levers of being a PM and go deeper depending on the company.
Okay, awesome. Now that you're here, you have a multitude of experience. Where are we going from here? Where do you think we're going from here?
Nowhere but up. I think it's a really great time, I think, to be learning Power BI, just because there's just so much happening at the company. And like I mentioned, you know, we as one of the great things about Power BI is we can partner with all these different tools. And I think that's just going to get even more true. Power BI is showing up in more places related to Office. We're getting deeper with Synapse. There's just so many new ways that we're going to be able to leverage Power BI across the whole Microsoft stack.
Yeah.
And so I think it's going to continue to grow. I think it's going to be a really fun ride.
You know, the viewers would want to know, what is your favorite Power BI feature? I love goals.
This is hard as a PM because I want to say my own feature I create.
So what was that?
So in Power BI, we have a set of features that we call quick create, and basically get started really quickly. I'm looking at a table of data and maybe I just paste it into Power BI and visuals are automatically generated for me. Or maybe I'm looking at a list in SharePoint and I click the Power BI button and I get a whole report based off of that list.
Yeah.
And I think it's a really great feature because it's one of those, I think, gateway features into the rest of Power BI.
Okay.
So, you know, you don't have to already have these deep technical analyst skills to start using Power BI. You just need to have data, which we've already said everyone does.
Yeah.
And then you can just get started. And then you can start learning about the other parts of Power BI as you need to. Uh-huh. So like, oh, okay, I love this report that was started for me, but I need to tweak this thing. Like I want it to be a different color or something.
Right.
So then you start exploring the formatting features, or what other charts do Power BI have? Can I make new columns? And then you might discover DAX. And so it's a really great way to slowly build yourself into the product instead of having to, like, you know, jump off a cliff and learn everything.
Okay, noted. Quick create. Here we go. Quick create. I'm writing it down. I know it exists. I've played with it a little bit, but not so much. So I think that's a great tip. Okay, any thoughts for Power BI women and joining our user group and volunteering?
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is just to start getting involved. I'm always, and it doesn't always appear that way, but I'm not a super social person naturally, so I have to kind of push myself. But every time I do, I'm glad that I do, because any way you can start to get involved, it just, I don't know, becomes like a way of pushing you further in, and you start learning, meeting new people and networking and finding new experiences. So just, even if you're a little nervous, just try and push yourself out of that comfort zone and jump in and just start it. You have to start.
That's a great advice, right? And people can start user groups within their company. Because mm-hmm. remember, we had the internal Power BI Geeks, you know. And so you don't necessarily have to have like an external worldwide one. You could have one within your own little community.
Exactly.
Your group of friends.
Your team. You start building Power BI within your team, and then you start pulling other people in from across the company, and then you can just build from there. Starting with little steps is always a lot easier than just trying to make that big jump into like, oh, I'm just going to start a whole new group from scratch. I mean, some people can do that. That's great. But little steps, easier to mark progress.
Okay, cool. Well, so you heard it from Amanda. So join us at aka.ms. Power BI Women, and either join a user group or start your own. And if you need help, you know, you can always contact us via Twitter or via the community.
Yes.
But Amanda, any final words of encouragement for us today? And of course, we value your time. We thank you so much for joining us today. But any other final thoughts?
Know that you're in the right place. You know, you're doing the right things, you're learning the right skill set, and it's only going to benefit you from here. So just have confidence that you're doing the right thing.
Thank you so much today. It was, again, great seeing you in person. And, you know, we all look forward to working together again in the future.
Yes, thank you for your time.
Thank you.